Good morning, everyone. It is Wednesday, December 13, right? And we are listening to a little bit of Max Richter this morning. I cannot tell you how wonderful it is to be home now. And first, let me just start off by just saying that I didn't upload yesterday, and I'm okay with that. It was the first day, first morning that I haven't uploaded a morning talk with you, and it's okay. I felt a bit, yesterday morning, I was getting ready to leave from Bari, and I had a roommate, and we were talking, and I had such a nice connection with him, I didn't feel like doing the morning talk and taking my way from that experience and that I was having in myself, and such a beautiful connection with a person. I am here this morning just to share, and I have some time to talk because I'm officially on holiday. Life is so beautiful and miraculous, and I know it's so funny as I say these things that I know that you're with me, like if you're with me, whatever, it doesn't matter. Nothing matters. Life is so continuous and so beautiful and elegant and graceful and full of so much opportunity to witness and feel, and this is my life. My life is just a continuous event or a stream of events. However I relate to it, however I see it, however I judge it, however I label it, however I want to experience it, it's all there and it's all my choice. It's all my choice and all my free will. I don't know, every belief that we have, every belief, it's like my free will, every belief, I believe this, my free will to pick up this coffee and drink it. My free will is constantly there. It is how I define it. And if someone doesn't believe in free will, it becomes their truth. A belief is only something you keep thinking that I've learned and that I know. But then again, at the same time, what is truth? What is the ultimate truth? Is truth in conforming? Is truth in being how other people want you to be so you can behave in that way? This is everywhere around me, it seems. And I enjoy the fact when people are free and not concerned. When I'm free within myself, I feel as though I'm freeing people from concern. I'm freeing myself from concern. And I use humor and I use gratitude to be in a space of acceptance, of a space of isness, and let everything rise and fall without any kind of labels and judgments. And life is so beautiful like that. My life changes so constantly. I cannot even believe that I did this Levi's, choreographed this Levi's fashion show, and that experience was just an experience. I can label this experience as being valuable, but valuable for what? Valuable for me to learn and continue to grow and go on. Or that I let go of my egoic self and that I need to achieve and that I need to, or that I feel good in the having of that, you know, of like that. Of course, these things rise and fall, but what is it? It's all transient, and it seems to be quite transparent when I start to look at it. My life, my world, my... it can really, like, touch my heart, because... probably the music. It influences me to have just appreciation of the choice that I can choose to be. Me and myself, and there are so all the people on the planet, has a choice to follow their free will and to be in this amazing, amazing experience and mysterious thing called life. And life is around you all the time. And I think it includes everything, you know, non-dualistic and labeling. You would not know love if you didn't know hate. And it's like a game. You wouldn't know up without knowing down. It's all on the same stick. You know, it's like all on the same stick. Reality is all on the same stick. So I choose in my journey, only on my journey, not your journey, because my journey is my journey, and I can be constantly aware. And I think the consciousness is awareness. What is it that is aware of myself talking right now? What is it that is aware of the reactions of other people? What is it that is aware of the world? What is it that is aware of the beauty in all things, in all things, in all living things, in all things? The beauty is a choice. And I cannot know that beauty without knowing the ugly, whatever that is. They're all labels. So therefore, for me, it's just a simple observation that there is no right or wrong. Like, how would you know right without knowing wrong? It's the yin and yang. It is so beautiful. Music is affecting me, maybe at the moment. But it's also the feeling of the coming to know that I have this choice and this constant choice of unconditional love that I have in my journey. It doesn't mean it's your journey. It doesn't mean it's anybody else's journey, because a belief, like I said, is only something you keep thinking. And when you keep thinking something, it becomes your truth and it becomes your reality. I really believe that. And because I have the free will to believe that in myself, and that I like that game. And ultimately, there is no truth other than there's no right or wrong. There it just isn't. And I know that's very difficult for a lot of people, because religious dogmas has told you what you have to do to get into the kingdom of heaven. And whatever that dogma is, or whatever any conformity is, or societal rules and regulations for you to follow, for you to be whole and complete as a person, because something outside of you told you you needed to be that. It doesn't make sense to me anymore. It just doesn't make sense to me anymore. So therefore, I have this observation within me, this light that is looking at everything. Because I am light. I am made of the same thing that stars are made of. I'm made of the same thing that everything is made of. We know that subatomically. Scientists know this. Quantum physics knows this. They all know this. But there are people who are not going to agree with me, and there are going to be a people, but that's beautiful. It's beautiful, because that is your prerogative to think and be and do and have anything that you also want right in your life, right? Perhaps the things that you've been conformed to believe is what is keeping you from yourself and from enjoying your life. Why are we not here to enjoy our lives? I am here to enjoy my life. I am here to allow the isness of all that is. That is my choice, my prerogative. As I started on this journey and I look at this journey, and I can have memories of my past, which is, I'm questioning at the moment what memories are. They're nostalgic. They bring nostalgic feelings, and they can feel good. And if it feels good, I like to feel good. It's not that I don't feel it is labels, right? The negative or the annoyance of a situation or circumstance that may have perhaps rise from the conditioned mind. But the simple fact that this moment has never happened is right there. It is isness. So any label is, I don't know. It seems as though everything that I've learned has brought me to this point in my life. But I can't really, I don't know. It seems like a flash, it's just all gone into this moment. Like everything, like it's just flashed, bump, done. I was born and now I'm here, 51 years old. It's Christmas time, it's, I don't know. All of these happenings or this isness of what is, it's all in my own mind. And my mind labels and judges and, but my awareness, my center and my awareness doesn't, because I can choose it. And I think that's beautiful, an absolute miracle. And so therefore it tells me that I am a miracle. Conditions do not tell me the truth of anything. It's conditions. The truth for me is fundamentally right there in my own isness. My isness of being, and I can choose how I want to respond to all of it. It is like enlightening. I'm woke. I'm woke. And I feel expansive and I feel infinite. My fear of death is not there. I'm not afraid. I'm not afraid of many things. I'm not afraid. I'm just not afraid. When you start observing yourself and your reactions to everything that is around you, and you observe it, there is no fear. Because only fear, what do they say? The only fear is fear itself. It really, I don't know, it's part of my journey. And I share it because I have compassion. And in this way of observing, in my own free will, it seems, I can observe it and I get to choose. And as I get to choose, I realize that I get to choose how I want to spend this experience, or this spiritual being having this human experience, if you will, which is said over and over because there's something there, maybe. But as I have my own free will, my own choice, and I observe people and may not like how they behave, or they feel uncomfortable how I behave or how I have to be for them to feel better, or vice versa, because it's conditioning. You know, the simple fact that I don't really like people who are rude, and that I don't like people that are, that's my preference. It's not a judgment anymore. People are how they are. I don't take anything personal. The assumptions of things are going. I have no judgment. I just don't have any judgment. Why would I judge? Ultimately, it's judging yourself, because when you judge other people, you judge yourself. And from this point of view, life is so incredible, absolutely incredible. And the impermanence of constructs is just, it all goes there. And I feel like my mind is saying right now that I sound like a broken record, because that is it. That is it, my friends. That is the most beautiful, beautiful thing that I am experiencing in this journey. And you are me and I am you, and I share it because it's so beautiful. It's like beautiful. And so any kind of idea of harm that you would do to yourself, or that you would not accept within yourself, or that you would think that you were some kind of victim, is obsolete within that isness for me, because I'm tired. I get tired of judging myself because of the opinion of others. And then I'm like, why am I here? I want to choose how I want to be. I do. Because I am my God. And I'm not under any kind of religious dogma. I went through all of that and it gave me nothing. these constructs of how I had to be so I could fit in to everybody, so I could feel most comfortable. Well, in the desire of freedom within myself promotes behaviors and risks and change to get familiar with that pureness, or the pureness of my being that is there, and that's how I choose to live my life. I don't read the news because it comes from lack. It is a game. How or whatever I want to believe in, I don't read the news. I'm not going to be bothered by what I choose to do, who I choose to work with. My journey is my journey. I want to be with people, and I can sit here and explain and try to define my day, which is impermanent, because at the moment I will ask for something, and the next moment I will ask for something else, maybe, perhaps. I don't know, because all I know is the isness of the now, if that makes any sense. As I started on my own journey, I'm just going to read something to you that is really profound for me, and maybe it will resonate with you. I don't really know. And at the same time, I don't really care, because it's my own thing. But in the careness, I care about how you want to be, just how you want to develop yourself, how you want to be, how you want to share, how you want to be in the world. And it's your prerogative to be however you want to do. And if you want to judge and label, do it, do it, do it. That's what I mean, that I don't care, because that's your prerogative. But I care about my own journey. So, and I let go of that, because everything is impermanent. Because truth cannot be defined. A truth is only something you keep thinking, maybe, perhaps. Love. Anyway, I'm going to go on. This is written in a book called The White Book, and it's channeled by an entity called Ramtha. And Ramtha has a school of enlightenment in the United States. I'm not sure where it is. I think it's New York, or I'm not sure exactly, but you can look it up. Ramtha, R-A-M-T-H-A. And the entity says, I say in this audience that there is no grander teacher than you, and that each is wholly responsible for his own life's accord. For are we not the ones who in thought do not do one thing, and it is not the manifestation of that one thing that will teach our thoughts to be more refined? You can take a man and put him in prison, into the smallest, darkest, filthiest pit there is, but you will never imprison his mind and his thinking. A man with his body stifled is still active in thought. And he, through contemplative thought, will reason with himself and teach himself and judge himself. I do not acknowledge good or evil, only life. If it moves an entity to slay another, or to do it within his soul by simply thinking about it, one is not greater than the other. For what you have done in your thoughts, you have already done. And there is not one entity that has not cleaved another in his thoughts. That entity, in either case, needs to express that for his purposeful understanding. And I wish you to understand that one who participates with the slayer in his expression is not the victim of the slayer, for he has contemplated possibility of perhaps being burned or cleaved in two or molested, and because he has contemplated it and it is fearsome, he has drawn it right to his doorstep. Thus the one who needs to molest and the one who needs to be molested, because he needs to understand it, are brought together for the experience. In the understanding called God, nothing is evil. Everything is an experience that provides wisdom. That is my answer to you. And when man is no longer condemned by his brothers and realizes that he is not evil in his being, that he is God in his being, and understands that he is wholly loved and supported by the life force called God, he will no longer need to experience war or rape or murder or other such acts in order to understand his worth and value. And when man frees himself from this restrictive consciousness, with its laws and plans and rules, he will find the joy and peace of being that will allow him to love himself and the whole of mankind, and allow all to be in the freedom of their own willful designs. Then he will love as God loves. Then he will be as God is, the platform which nurtures and supports all life. So be it. That is something for yourself to ponder, and something that really resonates with me. It just does. It resonates and lights up my whole being, and I feel grateful for all of that, to know that. Or to, I don't know. But that's my truth, and I make it my truth. And at the same time, I let go, and I just be. I'm awake. I'm woke, as they say. I'm awake. And it feels amazing. Just feels so amazing. I'm so grateful for every moment, opportunity there is in my life. It constantly changes. I am not a person. I'm the isness of everything that is around me. And I get to choose how I want to be. And people may be not like that, or like it, or agree with it, or not agree with it. It is the beauty of their own unique perspective and choice. But it is a perspective. It's just like mine is a perspective. I believe in manifestations, but I believe none of it matters. Nothing matters in life. Nothing matters. So I'm going to go with the stream of my experiences to show up and do them, and go with my feelings. My feelings are the indicator of my future. And I have a choice in that. I have a choice in how I label those feelings. And I allow all that is, isness. Isness is seeing through. The source that creates miracles is right inside of you. And that source that creates everything is inside of you. Beautiful music, beautiful being you are. Gratitude, gratitude, gratitude of the isness is where I live. And I'll continue to live there. And life is so beautiful. I want beauty. But in order to know beauty, you must know ugly, I guess. It's all the same thing. I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you all. Love so much. Thank you for watching me. And have a great day. Lighten up. Love you so much. Bye.